You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Big Brother. Mainstream media. Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
We are now into hour number two. Coming up, new GOP border security bill removes border fences. We'll look at some of the richest 80 people in the world and how they made their wealth. 35 of them are American citizens. Courthouse News reports DOJ asked judge to put BP fine at $11 billion. Drone flies through congressional hearing. A drone crashes carrying methamphetamine. That's just some of what's coming up today. Monsanto earnings fall 34% after a year of global protest. Also, top five natural antihistamines. If you're sick of being on stuff like Claritin D or Zyrtec D that makes you higher than a kite, we'll break that down as well. Right now, let's go to your calls. Stefan, Debbie, Riley, Howard, Rick, and others. Stefan in New York, you're up first. Go ahead.
Hey, how you doing, Alex? I have a quick comment because I heard you guys talking about this, so I frantically tried to call you guys. No one is really talking about, all right, if you want to carry a firearm and you want to drive around, you can't leave it a surprise where when a cop says, oh, can I get your registration from your glove box? You go, oh, okay, let me reach for my glove box where there's a gun inside. You know what I mean? You can't leave. You have to tell the officer, listen, if you're carrying it, you know, legally, you have to at least address to the officer first, okay, I'm going to reach for my registration. I do have a firearm in my glove box. Would you like me to show identification for it? And so on. If you leave it a complete surprise, you have to understand these cops...
Oh, I totally agree with you that they didn't know the, quote, procedure to not get shot when you have a gun by the police. I mean, really, when you get the concealed carry, you get a red carpet treatment because they know you've been vetted, background checked, gone through the training, and they know that statistically the lowest crime rate out there is concealed weapons carriers nationwide. In fact, it's just unbelievable because you're law-abiding, so you're wanting to go out there and jump through the hoops, even though it's unconstitutional, to do it. It shows the group that is... In fact, concealed carry in articles I've seen have lower crime rates than off-duty police officers. So that's a very, very low crime rate right there. The problem is once they get everybody to get concealed carries, they can then change the concealed carry laws and turn a right into a privilege. I used to be a big critic of concealed carry, but now it's moving towards open carry and just the Second Amendment. So I was somewhat wrong about concealed carry all these years, and I now intend to get it. Because it's actually evolved into more of a Second Amendment in most states. So we're winning the fight overall. It's very, very exciting. The problem is they're going to pull some big false flags to try to demonize the Second Amendment. Go ahead.
Oh, yes, and I'm prepared for that because I also do have my concealed and carry. And to be honest, there was a story where I was driving from Florida to Georgia, and me and my brother, we were picking up a brand-new pickup truck, and we're driving in a Volkswagen that really only cost about $3,000. Right, and here we are driving with $15,000 cash. We have. I look like I'm Mexican because I'm dark. So here you have people with New York accents driving from Florida with Florida plates, with New York accents. They look dark. They have $15,000 cash on them. I got pulled over for tint because my tints were too dark. And what happened was I was packing at the time. And what happened was what kept me from getting shot because I saw this cop. Once he saw the money, he took a step back and he was like, okay, what the heck is going on in this car? And I let him know. I said, officer, we're buying a pickup truck. We have me and my brother and I, we both have firearms on us. We both have permits to carry these firearms. Point is you have to comply with these officers. If you leave it a surprise and you leave it up to an element of surprise to these cops,
the key is being calm and communicating. That then de-escalates and makes them not so nervous. I think it's a balance, though. The public needs to think about how to engage the police, and the police need to you know, not drink too much coffee and then go out and kill people. We'll be right back. Stay with us.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel Body Armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
When cells become toxic, they die early and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
Several months back, I started taking your Nixon iodine and your super meal. Prior to this, I was barely walking. Now I'm able to function as a human again.
InfoWarsLife.com. You've heard the callers of the show.
Your products are great. I use DNA Force. I use X2.
Thank you.
Super Male Vitality and Lung Cleanse. Every day, they're great stuff.
Whether it's Survival Shield, Nascent Iodine, or DNA Force, Super Male Vitality, Super Female Vitality, Lung Cleanse, Fluoride Shield, Oxy Powder, I believe that all of these products will blow you away like they've done the thousands of other customers that have visited InfoWarsLife.com.
That's true. Just amazing what it's able to do to actually detox in the body. It's great stuff.
Check out InfoWarsLife.com today and the entire line of groundbreaking, cutting-edge, hardcore products. Sold out for weeks due to the difficult and extensive proprietary process behind its creation, the exclusive InfoWars Life Secret 12 formulation is now back in stock. This ultra-clean vitamin B12 nutraceutical has been carefully crafted and developed over the last 2 years and is based on cellular science of how your body actively absorbs essential nutrients. Most forms of vitamin B12 are highly processed and synthetic and could not be properly absorbed by the body. Secret 12 is a binary of nutraceutical grade, bioavailable coenzyme forms of B12, methylcobalamin, the same kind used in B12 injections, and adenosylcobalamin, the most bioactive form that has been created with our proprietary process. Secret 12 is taken by mouth, right on the tongue, and then swallowed. No needles, no injections. Don't take my word for it. Try it for yourself. Discover the secret. Secret 12. Supplies of Secret 12 are very limited. Secure yours today at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
We are back live, ladies and gentlemen. And if you go to InfoWars.com, you can see a lot of the latest breaking news and top stories. Texas cops jail woman for walking without a license. You cannot make that up. We're going to be breaking that story down at the bottom of the hour. Doomsday clock set to move 1 minute closer to midnight. We're going to be going over that. I already covered this and played the clip last hour. Sleeping Illinois police officer says it's illegal to record a police officer in public. Senator Schumer says sleeper cells might make bombs with household items. So now stuff under your sink may be terrorist. That is just some of the news up on InfoWars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. Freedom of speech. Boston mayor bans bad-mouthing of Olympics. And Facebook says they will filter out what they deem to be fake news. Anyone, I guess, criticizing Zuckerberg, who met with the communist Chinese last month to decide how to censor the U.S. internet. I mean, that was in the news. He met with them to learn how they censored. And now, oh, that's what China says. They censor what they call fake news, and then they go further. They arrest who they call fake news. So cops are saying you can't videotape them in public, and Zuckerberg wants to censor the internet. Does this sound like a free country? So we need the good police to speak out against this and say, no, you do have a right to film in public and to not go along with this. But it's not just the police. They're at the bottom of the political rung. We need to target politically the tyrants above them, the corrupt judges, the corrupt congressmen and women, the legislatures, the city councils, the mayors. We need to target them and call them out for the thugs they are. They need to be sued for a civil rights violation. This mayor telling people you better not criticize, telling city employees, even in your off time, you don't criticize by voice or on your Facebook or Twitter the Olympics coming here, or we'll fire you. You have no free speech when you work for the government. Man, that's crazy. That's not a free society. That's a system that wants to tell us to shut up and tell us what to do. But right now, let's go to your phone calls. Let's talk to Debbie in New Jersey. Debbie, you're on the air. Thanks for calling.
Hey, Alex. Thank you. I am retired New York police. I did 20 years. I retired in 2012. But I watched that video, and I have to say, I do agree with you. The cop definitely overreacted. But I have to say that in his defense, that we are trained to, you know, call the plate into headquarters and get a run back on the driver and whatnot before you exit the cruiser even. So they may have been given information through headquarters that the suspect was a criminal or maybe had a warrant.
Well, that's exactly what happened. I mean, they knew that one of the people had the driver reportedly had a criminal record, so they were already paranoid. And I don't know why they opened the glove compartment with a gun in it to get the registration out. I mean, obviously the cops are going to flip out when you do that. But then at that point, the guy put his hands up, the cop flipped out and killed him. So I don't think it's premeditated murder, but I mean, you just can't execute people because you get scared, in my view, when their hands are up.
Oh, I agree. I agree totally. It was really a bad judgment call.
Well, here's the good news out of the whole sad event. Al Sharpton's not going to be able to create race riots out of this because the officer basically initiating it is black. I think it's a great illustration, though it's sad, that this is about people being scared, not about racial issues. Because black cops shoot white people all the time. It doesn't become a big issue because there isn't a George Soros movement to hype it up. Let me ask you this question as a retired police officer. What do you think about the fact that George Soros bragged last week and they released the documents that his Open Society group that helped fund the overthrow of Ukraine is now openly trying to finance anti-police demonstrations? I mean, clearly he's doing that for some end game rule. Is he testing to see if they can start civil unrest? Then Obama can come in and act like a savior? Or what do you think the plan is? Because George Soros, more than anybody, calls the shots in the White House.
Well, I would agree that they're definitely trying to make Obama look like the savior saint. Isn't that what every crisis has become, that he runs in as the savior? Let me tell you, this is why I resigned in 2012. My uncle and a friend of mine who was a Fed both told me what was going to happen down the line and advised me, if you got your 20 in, to get out before it becomes worse. And that's exactly why I did it.
But we were told from federal sources in 2012 and 13, we're on record with the Northeast Intelligence Group, Hagman on the show, who also had similar sources, saying that that was coming. This is very interesting. Tell me specifically what your family members that were feds or are feds told you was coming 3 years ago.
I was told that Obama was going to get reelected. Now, when I was retiring, it was around April. And I said, oh, I don't know about that, but I listened. And he told me, he says, the militarization is going to get worse. And, you know, you should get out now and get your pension before you could possibly lose it. I really wasn't completely convinced, but it scared me enough. And then, of course, then I started listening to you. And that woke me right up.
Did your family members that are feds, did they retire, or are they trying to retire now?
Oh, no. Some of them are still on. Yeah.